Hello, and welcome to Birmingham Public Library Presents. We are so glad to have you with us today, and we have a new feature that we'd like to tell you about. The library has started a new set of programs called BPL at Night. We'd like you to visit us in the evenings, not only when the library is open all day long, but we'll be featuring some different artists and performing artists, as well as other groups from around our area during the evening hours at our libraries. We were very fortunate during the month of March to have a new local theater group called Muse of Fire, and they have two of our guests today are from Muse of Fire. We have Elizabeth Bradley, who is the director, and we have Gordon Pate, who in their upcoming production will be playing the Archbishop of Canterbury. Good afternoon and welcome.
Hi.
Thank you.
Thanks for having us.
We would like to hear a little bit about Muse of Fire. What is it? Can you explain a little bit about it?
Muse of Fire, we like to say, is a new and innovative Shakespeare project down at Sloss Furnaces. And it started this past fall. I took 8 of my favorite scenes, my favorite Shakespearean scenes, and set each one in a different location at Sloss, and then took small groups of audience members on a little tour through the footpath of Sloss, and we did the scenes. And this spring, we're expanding into a full-length production of Henry V, which we're very excited about. It'll be 2 days in May, the 19th and 20th of May, during the day, and it's going to be a full kind of, audiences aren't required to sit the whole time. They can stand up and shout if they'd like, but there are chairs, and this is not the tour through that the fall showcase was. But we like to think that we're approaching Shakespeare from kind of more of a deconstructed angle, where we're stripping it down to, I cut the play to 1.5 hours, just so that we can get through it much quicker. And because it's outside at Sloss, it starts to get warm in May by the end of Act Two. And it's kind of an aesthetic that's a little bit modern, but very familiar, but just kind of overall pretty unique. So we're excited about it.
Well, how do you think you can make Shakespeare relevant in this time and place, in a contemporary setting?
You know, it's interesting because the most kind of insightful comment that I've heard about the project that we're trying to do is from Kathy Crenshaw, when she's one on the Sloss Foundation. Her family's very connected to Sloss, obviously. And when we were talking about it, she said, you know, what I like about the idea of doing Shakespeare here is that there are so many answers to be found in Shakespeare to contemporary problems. And when you put the work in a space like Sloss, it kind of turns up the volume on those answers, which was such a neat way of looking at this very kind of classical, familiar work in a space that's not familiar, and that kind of helps this dusty sometimes work feel more relevant to today by putting it in a new space.
And Muse of Fire's slogan is?
I could turn around and show you, but I think I'll miss the camera mark here. I don't know if you, pardon my sound pack. I don't know if you can see it there. It's same bard, now in industrial strength.
A great quip for being at Sloss Furnace and being part of the heritage of Birmingham.
Exactly.
And the iron industry.
Exactly.
Well, Gordon, what drew your attention to Muse of Fire?
Shakespeare. I'm a Shakespeare fan. I have been a Shakespeare fan all my life. I taught English, went to law school, got away from theater, and then in the last 5 or 6 years, I've really sort of gotten back involved, mainly in Shakespeare. And I actually just got through teaching the 6th, 7th, and 8th graders at Advent their Shakespeare model of Macbeth and Julius Caesar and Romeo and Juliet. And I heard about what Elizabeth was doing. I think I read about it after it had happened back in November. And I was so pleased to see somebody making this sort of effort, and not only to make the effort here, but to make it in a relevant way. And I get so disappointed sometimes at the way we present Shakespeare to our kids, and then we wonder why they think it's old and boring and out of shape. And I think what Elizabeth is going to do is going to really give Birmingham and especially a lot of the kids a chance to come in and see a Shakespeare that they're not familiar with, that's alive someone said about Shakespeare, the characters are free artists of themselves. So that's what got me kind of turned on to the deal. And I talked to Elizabeth, and I had an audition in a good many years, but I thought it was worth the effort, and I'm looking forward to working on this.
And you will be playing the Archbishop of Canterbury.
The ever-devious Archbishop of Canterbury, mm-hmm. who plans this whole idea to get Henry's attention and Parliament's attention away from taking over his church lands. So let's direct Henry toward France and see if we can't get things started over there.
Well, I too found out about MusiFire after their fall showcase and read about it in the paper and had the very fortunate opportunity to contact Elizabeth about doing the scenes they did at the library.
Well, that was so much fun. I'm so happy that we got to go down and do that sneak preview there. It really was delightful.
We did have a great deal of fun that night. And when you staged the scenes from Henry V at the library, I was most struck during the performances, the costumes that the actors were wearing and the implements they were carrying, because they're not what I guess you would consider your traditional props.
Right. Well, I should have brought one of the staffs with me. They're in my trunk. If you want to stop at any point, I'll go get a staff and come in here and threaten everyone with it. But they're very ornate. They were made for us by one of the apprentices down in the Metal Arts program at SLOS. And there are these three long staffs with all of this intricate ironwork all around and then some rusted wire wrapped around one of them. That's my favorite. I carry that one around and threaten the actors with it. Part of what has been interesting to me in undertaking this project has been using what's on hand. And so using the props and the materials that exist at SLOS and using the costumes that we can cobble together from actors' wardrobes or from found pieces or from kind of whatever. It's a very catch-as-catch-can production, very bare bones and guerrilla style in terms of our production values sometimes, but not in terms of the quality of the presentation, we like to think. But that was what was fun about coming down to the library also, was that that was a brand new setting for us. And there's a lot more that was breakable at the library, so we had to be a little bit, we run around SLOS like crazy fools and not break anything. But using the environment of the library was what was interesting to me for those scenes. We found a way to use the book return, and we used the circulation desk, and we used the escalators to come down, and we used the big balcony that was up there with the lights. And that's kind of a reflection of our aesthetic as a group, I think, which is that we won't add very many set pieces to SLOS because SLOS is the set. And coming into the library, which is kind of a fun way to use that same purpose, but with different tools, I guess.
Well, how did you choose Henry V as your spring production?
I wanted to, for our first full-length production, I wanted to kind of come out of the gates, as it were, with something that isn't usually undertaken as a play. A lot of times, and also in the spring, I think a lot of people will usually focus on comedies, which was my first impulse. And then I thought, well, what if I did something that was kind of higher energy, and I want to run around, and I want to have big weapons, and it's not exactly right for Midsummer Night's Dream. Although maybe it is. Maybe that'll be how we do Midsummer Night's Dream next year. But I've written on Henry V when I was in graduate school. That was a major portion of my Shakespeare experience at grad school was Henry V. And I wanted to do something that was fairly warlike, adrenaline fueled, and then also I found Sylvester, and Sylvester is Henry V, Sylvester Little Jr., and he came out and did the showcase with me, and that kind of cemented it for me that I said, well, I guess maybe this is the right play to do for our first big coming out party, because he's outstanding, but also the work seemed to fit best with SLOS and the spring. You can't really do Macbeth in the middle of May with butterflies around. I mean, you could, but.
Right. Got to wait for the ice and the snow and and the wind. But I am just so impressed with the cast Elizabeth has put together, excluding me, because this is, I was telling someone the other day, I'm a good bit older than the next oldest one, and there is so much energy and so much talent from Henry right through all the comedy parts and everything. And I am really pumped up about the quality of acting that Birmingham's going to see come May.
Well, can you share with us the dates again, the times, and where we're located.
Okay. Sloss Furnaces is at First Avenue North, and you should go to slossfurnaces.com for directions, because I'm not good at giving directions, so that's it's not safe for anyone to trust my directions. Go to slossfurnaces.com for directions. But the dates are May 19th and 20th. The show's going to start at 1 o'clock on Saturday, which is the 19th. The gates open at 10, and on Sunday, the gates open at noon. We're hoping to have a music component to the day, but that I would hate to give details about that, and we're still working on it. Tickets are $20, and there are discounts for students and seniors. And you can find all of the information about the show itself on my website, which is myspace.com/museoffire. But yeah, I think that's 19th and 20th, 1 o'clock. Look for the information online. Probably have some more press coming up, but that's where
we look forward to seeing you on the 19th and 20th of May, and for a lot more of excitement to come into Birmingham's theater scene.
Yes, thank you so much.
Thank you for being with us.
Thank you.